tool-free commissioning. In this example, we are going to use a touch panel PXM30E model. The device is already powered up and connected to a BACnet network. When the device is started for the very first time, it's required to select the proper orientation for the screen. Confirm the selection with the small arrow in the center of the screen. Next step is to sign in as administrator, using the default password, which is 1BT with ONBT uppercase. You are then immediately forced to change the default password to the project-specific one. Now, a commissioning wizard is displayed, giving the possibility to quickly setting up some specific settings, like the device name, the instance number, the description for this device, the location and the time zone. Furthermore, in the right side, a couple of additional system information are available. Tapping on Next, the wizard gives the possibility to set up the network parameters, like enabling or disabling the DHCP function, or setting up a fixed IP address, with the proper subnet mask and router. SNMP option is also available to be enabled, then it's even possible to change the BACnet UDP port from the default one, if necessary. The wizard completed the initial configuration, so just tap on the screen to go on. It's now possible to access the device remotely via internet browser, using the just defined IP address, and log in with the administrator credentials. The touch panel PXM30E is now indicated as operational. Next step is to define the customer user for this specific project. So, navigate through configuration from the top bar, then users menu from where we can find the add user option. Define here the username, the role, the user language, date and time format, and finally define a strong password. Confirm then with add user. We can now proceed with the assigned device procedure. Navigate through configuration from the top bar, then assign devices menu. Start the discovery to scan the devices on the network, and click on assign command for each device we are going to assign. The assignment has been now completed. Navigate now through the object view from the top bar and assign devices, and operate to test the functionalities of your connected device. As example, we will now change the manual operating mode from off to auto. When an alarm appears, it's directly indicated on the element. To have a better view of the pending event and more comfortable operation, navigate from the top bar to Events, where we can find the list of all the pending events. The next step will be to integrate the data points for the operations. Navigate through Operations from the top bar, then Plant View. Under Default Site, there is at the moment no data points available yet. Click on the Hardware Tool icon on the right side, then Tools and Data Point Integration. In the prompted page, we will recognize the devices we have just assigned. With the templates, a set of data points is predefined for being integrated. Select now the device, and then click on Integrate. The result of the integration will be indicated under the status information and, as well, the space occupied in the memory of the Desigo control point device. With Advance, it's possible to adapt the predefined settings of the templates, for instance, to add or remove specific data points from the integration. But it's not recommend to overwrite default templates, because these changes would be persistent in case, from HQ, some updates to the default templates would be provided. So, we recommend to always save the customized template with a different name. Confirm any changes with Apply. When changes have been done in a template, it is required to integrate once more. Now, the building structure, the plans, and all the elements fitting the requirements of the used template are visible and available for the operations. As we did before, for example, the manual operating mode.